Hi guys, this is Abby. I'm not Key today. Key is Abby today, and welcome to my show. On my hand now, there are tons of letters from my audience. And today, I will read for you one of them, which is named Secret Love. Are you ready? This is the love letter. Woman hesitates to reveal secret love for college. Dear Abby, I am a single woman in my early 30s who has never been married. I recently fell in love with a wonderful man with whom I spent a great deal of time. He is unaware of the intensity of my feelings, and I'm afraid of telling him out of fear of rejection. There are a couple of addition concerns. He's 15 years my senior and a medical doctor. I am a social worker in a lower economic class. In addition, we are of different religions, but we have similar spiritual beliefs and values. He is also my co-worker. I am very interested in pursuing a deeper relationship with this man, but would like to hear your advice first. Thank you for your thoughts on this. Longing for more in Chicago. Alright guys, now I will explain and show you how to use some useful words throughout this letter. Alright, first one, hesitate. What does it mean? Now, but firstly, repeat after me. Hesitate. Remember the first stress. Hesitate. Well done. It means to pause. To pause from saying or expressing something. In this case, the woman hesitates to reveal her secret love. Right? So, what is the next word? Reveal. Reveal. What does it mean? It means to, for example, this is my secret love, right? Inside my heart. And nobody knows that. But I reveal it. I tell my secret, or I show my secret to the others. So, one more time, repeat after me. Reveal. Reveal. Moving on to the next word, intensity. Intensity or intensity. Yes, remember to speak out the word, okay? One more time, intensity. That's right. It means the amount or how much something, right? The amount of something. In this letter, she used the intensity of my feelings. It means the strength of my feelings, all right? Next word is rejection. Now, you do like this, rejection. That's right. It means saying no to someone or rejecting someone, right? So this woman in my letter, she says she has a fear of rejection. Means she's afraid of being rejected. That's right. And moving on to the next word, it is pursue. Pursuing somebody. It means you run after them, right? You run after them and you try to catch them. Try to follow and try to catch them. And in this case, the woman is interested in pursuing a deeper relationship. It means she's trying to follow a more serious relationship with this man. That's right. You know, guys, by reading this letter over and over again, I realized that there are tons of useful phrases and expressions inside. So why don't we take a closer look and learn how to use them, all right? First one, in my early 30s. She says, I am in my early 30s. It means she is around 30, 31, 32, 33 or 34. Nobody knows exactly, right? So this is a very, very interesting way to tell your age, especially if you don't really want to give an exact number. So, for example, can you guess my age? When you come to me and you ask me, hey Abby, how old are you? And I would say, I am in my early 20s. Next one is very, very common, but very lovely one. Fell in love. Remember guys, to make the linking sound, you say, fell in love. That's right. Or the original form of it is fall in love. So remember, we fall, right? We fall in love. It means you have feelings for someone, right? In this case, this woman, she has feeling for this man. So she said, I fell in love with a wonderful man, a beautiful man, a wonderful or handsome guy, right? Next one is a great deal of something. Remember to make the linking sound, deal of. One more time. A great deal of. Okay, it means much, right? So in this case, she says, a great deal of time means much time, right? And remember, the noun here is an uncountable noun. Remember that, it's super, super important, okay? You don't say a great deal of books, but you can say a great deal of time or a great deal of money, because time and money are uncountable nouns. Next one will be unaware of. So remember to make linking sound if you can. It is be unaware of. Of. One more time. Be unaware of. That's right. That's right. It means you don't know, right? If you are unaware of something, means you don't know about something, right? And in this letter, she says, this guy, he is unaware of the intensity of my feelings. It means this guy, he doesn't know anything about how much this girl loves him. Next one is a couple of. Remember guys, one more time, linking sound here. So you say a couple of. That's right, a couple of. It means some. Well done. For example, I would say, I am traveling to Malaysia for a couple of days, right? Or you can say, I am traveling to Malaysia for some days. That's right. This is super easy to use, okay? Last but not least is a very interesting one. It is longing for more. It means, longing means the feeling of wanting or needing something or desiring something really badly. Right, so this woman, she's in Chicago, right? So she says, longing for more in Chicago. She is now living in Chicago and she's waiting for my thoughts. She's waiting for my response or some solutions for her problem. That's why she wrote longing for more in Chicago. Okay guys, we have learned some useful words and expressions throughout the letter. So moving on, I will ask you a lot of questions and you need to answer them as quickly and powerfully as possible, remember? Let's go with the first one. How old is she? How old is she? Is she in her early 30s? Is she in her late 30s? Is she in her early 20s? How old is she? Okay, Is she married? Is she single? Is she divorced? Okay, well done, well done. Who did she fall in love with? Did she fall in love with a wonderful man? Did she fall in love with an ugly guy? Did she fall in love with a wonderful woman? Did she fall in love with me? Who did she fall in love with? Okay, and did she spend a great deal of time with this guy? Did she spend much time with this guy? Did she spend a little deal of time with this guy? How much time did she spend with this man? Has she told him how she felt about him? Has she revealed her feelings for this man? How many years is he older than her? Is he 15 years older than her? Is he 30 years older than her? Okay, next. What is his job? What does he do? What is her job? All right. Do they have the same jobs? Do they have similar jobs? What do they have in common? What do they have in similar? Alright guys, I hope that today you gained a number of exciting words and expressions via this secret love letter. Now, it's time I need to get back to my job. And till the next lesson, remember to have fun with English, okay? I'm Tauki, and catch you later! Bye-bye!